here, and of course, so is Javi. I'm telling you, this dog lives in my lap. All right, guys, as you can probably see, a little sneak peek, today we're going to be working on our controlled vowels again. This time we'll be chaining a little bit. I'll show you what chaining is, super fun, but first we have to sing our Hello There song. My turn first, you repeat. Hello there, how are you? It's so good to see you. We'll sing and be happy. We're all here together again. Beautiful. Let's get started with those R-controlled vowels. All right, I have our R-controlled vowels poster ready to go. We're going to practice saying the letters, the keyword, and the sound. My turn first, repeat after me. A-R, car, R. O-R, horn, or. E-R, her, er. I-R, bird, er. And the last one, U-R, burn, er. Nice. This goes really quick. I want to practice just the sounds. My turn first, repeat after me. It goes fast, like I said. Let's do it. R, or, er. Again, one more time. R, or, er. Excellent, let's move on to our learning target. All right, Javi and I are ready to do our learning target. Read along with us as I tap the words. I can decode words that have R-controlled vowels and suffixes. We already talked about R-controlled vowels. We're gonna get to suffixes in a second, but let's start with the word that's in a box. That tells us what we're going to do. This word is decode. It's one that's come up quite a bit. We spend a lot of time decoding during phonics because decoding is, reading. I'll draw a book to show that decode means read. Here they mean the same thing. Javi's getting comfy. Okay, quick sketch. All right, we're going to decode or read words that have R-controlled vowels like A-R, car, R, like I-R, bird, and U-R, burn, R-controlled vowels, just like we practiced with our poster, and suffixes as well. Now, it's been a little while since we've done a specific lesson on suffixes. Just as a reminder, suffixes are something that comes at the end of a word, changes the meaning just a little bit, like ing. Can y'all see that? Lower it just a little bit. ing is the ing suffix, also a glued sound. S is a suffix. Maybe I have a cat, and then if I get more than one, I have cats, and so is ed. ED is a tense suffix. It makes something happen in the past. Like, today I dance, yesterday I danced in the past. Okay. Again, these words are going to contain R-controlled vowels and suffixes. We're going to be doing chaining. I'll show you what chaining looks like right now. All right, friends, we're going to start by reading one word, and then I'll show you what the chaining looks like. The first word we're going to read or decode is this one, B-O-R-N. To help us decode or read this word, I want to identify and circle the R-controlled vowel. Take two fat fingers, circle that vowel. And did you circle O-R? If you did, great. O-R is our R-controlled vowel in this word. O-R says, O-R, horn, or. The sound is or. Now we're ready to blend the words since we identified and talked about that R-controlled vowel. Or, What's the word? Born. the word is born. Like your birthday celebrates the day on which you were born. Here's where the chaining comes in. I'm going to change one or two letters. For this one, it's just going to be one. And you have to read the word a little bit quicker because we've already talked about the other sounds. But here, my O-R, R controlled vowel, is going to turn into A-R. What does the A-R, R controlled vowel say? R, like A-R, car, R. What does the word say if A-R says R? Barn, barn. Like where all of the animals go to sleep at night on a farm is a barn. Farm also has some R-controlled vowels. Because we only changed one letter, you should be able to read the words, decode them faster. That's what makes chaining kind of fun. Okay, what if I change the B in barn to a Y? What word do I have now? Say the word in 3, 2, 1. Yarn. Y-R-N, yarn. Now this time when I chain, I'm gonna change two letters. I'm gonna take away my Y. I have to use my eraser. And I'm gonna change my A back into an O. Remember, what does that O-R, R-controlled vowel say? Or, O-R, horn, or. And I'm going to add a digraph. S-H. What does the S-H digraph say? Shh, like S-H, ship, shh. Awesome, decode or read the words. And we'll say the word together in 3, 2, 1. This is a hard one. Sh-or-n. Sh-or-n. Shorn. Shorn, like if you want to make wool, you have to shear the sheep. And in the past, sheep have been shorn. Kind of an unusual word that you don't hear a lot, but it has a digraph and an R-controlled vowel. That was our first round of chaining. Let's do another. I've got a nice clean board. That means we're ready for round 2 of chaining. Okay, here's your first word. Capital C, it's a me. L-A-R. Okay. Let's start by identifying and circling with two fat fingers the R-controlled vowel. What letters did you circle? A-R. There's our R-controlled vowel. What does A-R say? R. A-R, car, R. Nice. Let's blend the word. It's got a lot of sounds in it, including the C-L blend, which says cl, cl. We have k, u, r, k. What's this word? K, u, r, k. Clark. It's a name. In fact, I have a couple pairs of shoes that are Clarks. Ooh, and if I added an S, it would be a suffix. Clarks. But without that S, the word is just Clark. Got that. A-R. R, R-controlled vowel. So many R's. A-R, R, the sound, R-controlled vowels. Whew. You guys got it though. I'm gonna change some letters. We're going to take away the C-L blend, which says cool, 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 like in Clark. And I'm gonna change it to be that M. Read the word now. We'll say the word in 3, 2, 1, and 0. What's the word? Bark. Clark turned to b, ark, bark. Because I'm chaining, we can go a little bit faster. What if I change my B to an M? What's the word now? Arc. Arc. Mark. Nice. So many words with R controlled vowels. What if I change the K in mark to a digraph, an ending or final digraph? C-H. For those of you who might have forgotten, let's talk about the C-H digraph. C-H says ch-ch-ch, like C-H, chin, ch. So what's the word? Okay, if you remembered that mark started with mar, and then we just took away the K for the k, you can go march, 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 like the month or maybe like the way of walking. Or if you forgot that before it was mark and that when you took away the K, it just said mar, because that's a little bit tricky. You have to remember the last word. You could blend all the sounds. Arch, march. Nice decoding. What if I take away the M? That's it. What's my new word? Arch. March, take away the M, is arch. But then still, what if I change my CH digraph at the end? Oops, and I erased a little bit of my R. To a T. What does the word say now? Art, art, art. Excellent. What if I added a suffix? Remember, that's some letters that go on the end of a word and change it a little bit. I'm gonna add I-S-T. Read the word now. And we'll say the word out loud in 3, 2, 1. You got it, artist. Art, and then we added ist, ist. Artist, artist. Artist. Way to add that suffix. This word has both an R-controlled vowel and a suffix. Let's do another round. I'm gonna clean my board. Again, my board is clean. We're ready for round 3 of chaining. Here's our first word. S-T-A-R-T. Let's start by circling, identifying and circling with two fat fingers the R-controlled vowel. What letters did you circle? A-R. Now, we've seen this one a lot during chaining. What does the A-R, R-controlled vowel, say? R. We've seen this one a lot. You should be recognizing it as saying R. Okay, let's blend. S-t-art. S-t-art. Start. Touch your nose if you said start. Nice. Our first word is start, but what if I change this last T to a K? What does the word say now? Okay, let's blend. Stark. Stark. You could also have decoded the word by knowing that the first part of start is star, and then you add a k sound. Stark, stark, stark. Either way works. Stark means like complete, like a stark fear is, your whole body is filled with fear, which is something I hope doesn't happen to a lot of friends or any friends, but that's what stark means usually. Okay, and I'm gonna change a couple letters so that we have a K right here and an I right here and end with a K. T, hello, I'm taking away the K, replacing it with a T. Now you'll notice our R-controlled vowel has changed. Now it's I-R. What does the IR, R controlled vowel, say? Like IR, bird, Let's blend. Skirt. What's the word? Skirt. Like when I'm feeling fancy, I'll put on a dress with a nice poofy skirt. Beautiful. What if I change this I to an O? Haha, another new R-controlled vowel. What does the O-R, R-controlled vowel, say? Or. We saw this one earlier too. O-R, horn, or. Blend the word. Decode it. And what's the word? Skort. Skort. That's when you have a skirt in the front and shorts in the back. So it's like they combine the words shorts and skirt. It's called a skort. Kind of fancy. What if I take away the SK blend that says sk and I change it to an F? Read the word now. All right. And that word is fort. Ort. Ort. Fort. Let's add a quick suffix. S can be a suffix, means there's more than one. And now the word says forts. Forts. Like sometimes when it's rainy out and I'm kind of bored, I'll build pillow forts. Let's do it again. I'm going to wishy-washy my board. Okay, and our final chaining round starts with this word. P-O-R-C-H. Take two fat fingers, circle the R-controlled vowel, which here is O-R. We just got done with an O-R, R-controlled vowel, and it says or. How about this ending or final digraph? What does it say? We've seen this one too. It says ch, ch, ch. Let's blend. P, or, ch. P, or, ch. Porch. Like sometimes I like to have a glass of lemonade out on the porch. What if I change the O to another A-R, R-controlled vowel? What does the word say now? Arch. Parch. Which is like you're super duper thirsty. You're feeling kind of parched. But what if I change the A again to a different R-controlled vowel? E-R. What does the E-R R-controlled vowel say? Er. Like E-R, her, er. What does the word say now? Perch. And really quickly, what if I add the ed suffix? I go from perch to perched. Here the ed kind of makes a t sound. Perched. Like I saw a bird perched on a wire. Nice job practicing identifying and decoding words that both have R-controlled vowels and some suffixes. That was really tricky. Keep reading, keep writing, keep staying safe and playing, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye, scholars.
Wagner here, teaching that second grade math for you today. Let's go ahead and get all the materials that we need, the same materials, probably a stuffy to talk to, something to write with, something to write on. You probably already have it, but just in case, I'm going to give you a couple seconds to do it. All right, see you in a bit. All right, friends, same thing. Let's go ahead and look at our learning target today. And we're thinking about things that we know and things that we're wondering. Remember, something that you know, you'd be able to talk to somebody about it and give an example, such as adding, and then tell them it's when you're adding more. And something you're wondering is something you just can't remember and you can't quite explain. You need a little refresher on. So let's go ahead and look at our learning target. I will be able to add 4 two-digit numbers. Pretty simple, right? Let's read it one more time. I want you to read it with me. Ready? I will be able to add 4 two-digit numbers. Okay. I want you to think of, I wonder, and I know. I know you have a stuffy next to you. So go ahead and tell that stuffy something that you're wondering and something that you know. Give you a couple seconds to do that. Okay, so this one's pretty short today, and something that we'd probably be able to know already is that we know how to add, right? That's when we're adding more. And we talked about 4 two-digit numbers, but we might not remember. Some of you might. And that's when we're adding 4 two-digit numbers. So it's like 54 plus 26 plus 22 plus 31, right? They're two-digit, and there's 4 of them. All right, so we talked about everything there. I also want you to kind of have a little refresher of the strategies that we worked on this week so far. We worked on our place value chart, and we worked on finding that 10. Those are two strategies that we're going to use today to solve this. Okay, so I want you to keep those in your mind. In order to keep those in your mind, we're actually going to start with a warm-up. So your warm-up today, you're going to have a couple different equations, but the very first equation is 28 plus 32. And to kind of just refresh your memory, I want you to think of adding a 10, finding a 10, adding a 10. All right, go ahead and do that. Okay, because we have a couple more, I'm going to go ahead and jump in, and let's go ahead and look at this. So I'm going to use my 10 sticks and ones just to make it visual for some of us too. But if I'm looking at my one spot, I can see that 8 and 2 is going to make that 10. And we talked about if we have 10 or more in our ones place, what happens? And we carry that 10 over. So just so we can visually see it, I'm going to go ahead and show you here. I'm grabbing all my 10s. I got my 2 for my 28, my 3 for my 32. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then 1, 2 for 32. All right. So again, we talked about we're adding these all together. And if we see already with our 1s, we can see that 2 and 8 is already going to create 10. So if we put them together, we know they're going to make a 10, right? And we talked about this before. When we have our 10 ones, we're replacing it with a 10 stick. So it takes away our ones. As you can see, there's no ones right here anymore, but we do have a 10 stick. So since there's no ones, there's a 0 in our one spot. And then we have to count our 10 sticks. So we have, let's count by 10s, and you go ahead and clap them out. Ready? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. So that means that 28 plus 32 is going to equal 60. And it was easier for us to kind of see that. Again, we found in a one spot the 10s. We created that 10. We added it here, and it's making 60. And you can see, too, if we added an extra 10, say we added an extra 10 with our 2, that's 3, and 3 and 3 makes 6, so 60. All right, so I'm going to give you something a little bit trickier, just a little bit. Now, this is a missing number, right? So we have 29 plus blank equals 60. And you need to find the missing number. The idea here is that you're still kind of having the same idea that you just did here. You knew that these two are going to make that 10, which giving us a zero right there. We carried a 10 over, making our 6 right here. I want you to have that same idea of thinking here. You can see a 9 right here. You see the 0 here, so you know the 9 and something is going to make a 10, right? Because 9 and 1 make 10. I want you to try to figure out that number, and we'll talk a little bit more about it in a minute. Let's go ahead and figure out that number. Any way that you can. If that's mental, go ahead. If you're using your 10 sticks and 1s, go ahead. It's whatever you can do. Okay, because of time again, I'm going to kind of step in. It's okay if you're in the middle of this. We're going to kind of talk about it, okay? So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and just create 29. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. All right, I just created my 29. I know that my other number is probably going to have a 1 right there because I can see that there's a 10, right? And I know that a 9 and 1 make 10. So I know my other number is going to have a 1. Okay, that's what I know so far. In my head, I'm thinking, okay, what's 2 take away from 6? Well, 2 take away from 6 is 4, right? But I can't, this won't be 41. I can test it out, right? I have to see if 41. And then I know that if I add my other 10, I'm gonna get another 10. And that's leaving me with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I didn't get 70, I got 60. So I know that it's not 41. Well, if I take 1 away, I got 2 and 3, which make 5. And I know that my extra 1 right here is going to make that extra 10, giving me 3 and 3, which makes 60. Kind of tricky, but it's, if we think about it like that, you will see how that goes. And you can play with them and just to kind of get the pattern. And it's good because you already know the ones place. You already know what the other part is, right? You know 9 and 1 make 10. So let's try that again, okay? The answer would be 31, right? All right. So let's try that again and kind of practice it. It's a little tricky, and that's okay. We got another one. 57 plus blank equals 90. I kind of want you to go through the same kind of thinking pattern that we just did. Go ahead and solve it. Work with those numbers. See what you can get. Remember, you had that trick already in making that 10. Okay, because of time, we're going to go ahead and jump in. I can see the 7 over here in the 1 spot already, and I know that the missing number right here in the 1 spot, 7 and that number together is going to make a 10. Well, 7 and what makes 10? 3, right? So I know I'm going to have 3 ones over in this number. But first, I'm going to go ahead and create this number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 7 ones. 1, 2, 4, 6, 7. And then again, I know over here that I'm going to have 3 ones. And I know that I need to get to 9 tens, right? And knowing that I need to get to 9 tens, but I also know that this is going to create a 10. So that's already giving me an extra 10. So I have to think, okay, right now I have 5. Well, again, let's just check it out, right? Because if I put a 4 here, we know that's not going to work. We already know that if I put 4 tens here, it's not going to work because we have the extra 10 here. And 5 and 4 does make 9, right? But again, I'm creating an extra 10, so that would be 5 and 5. So if I have 3 here, let's see if that works. Again, we know that our 1s are going to make a 10, so we're going to replace it with a 10. And now we have, let's count them out. Clap out as we count by tens. Ready? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. So that means that we had 33. Again, 33. Even though we know that our tens, we know that 5 and 4 is going to make that 9. But remember that our ones together made 110, so we replaced it with a 10 stick. Okay, so see how that kind of helps us when we can see the pattern of adding those tens? All right, we're going to go ahead and move on. So like our learning target said today, that we are going to be adding 4 two-digit numbers. Well, 1, 2, there's 2-digit numbers, and there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 of them. We're going to be adding them, and today we're going to use both strategies to add them. I want you just to pick one, and I'm going to review both. So you have 52 plus 37 plus 12 plus 63, and it's either you're going to pick finding numbers that make 10 and adding it that way, or you can do your place value mat. I want you to think what's best for you. What really works for you when you're adding these 4-digit numbers? Is it going to really work for you to use the idea of finding a 10 and adding them that way? Or is it going to really work to do it this way, using your place value chart? I want you to think about what works best for you. So take a second to do that and go ahead and get started on your problem. Remember, either creating that of making a 10 and adding them that way, or your place value chart. You go ahead and just try. About 30 more seconds. Okay, So let's go ahead and think about making a 10 first. When I'm looking at these numbers, I want to find that 10 again, right? The two numbers in the one spot that's going to create that 110. So as I'm looking here, I can see it already. I can see that 37 and 63, because this 7 and 3 is going to make that 110. So if I roll up right here, do 37 plus the 63, I know that these two numbers is going to create that 10 for me. So they're going to be giving me that 0. I'm carrying that 1, right? So now this is 4 plus 6. Well, 4 plus 6 is what? 10. That gave me 100. So now I use those two numbers. And so what's next? Well, I like to add the bigger number. So I have 100 plus 52. And remember, it's just easier to add these numbers together. So we got 100 plus 52. And that means, let's just go ahead and count them out. Or you already know, you can already see 152 is going to equal 152. Or you go 100, and then you can count by your tens. Five, so we got 100, 110, 120, 130, 140, 150, and then we go up by two, 151, 152. So we can see that this is 152. Well, we still have to add 12. So now we got 152 plus 12. Again, we can do it counting by tens, right? So we see that we have 110, we're at 152. Let's go up 110, 152, 162. Nice job. Then we gotta go up 2 ones, so 162, 163, 164. 164. All right, now that we have the one way adding the tens, let's go ahead and look at the place value chart for this one. All right, so remember, we're just taking our numbers and we're putting them right in the tens and one spots. So we're going to look at 52. 52 has 5 tens, 2 ones. 37 has 3 tens, 7 ones. 12 has 1 10, 2 ones. 63 has 6 tens, 3 ones. And we're going to add them. All right. So again, I like to look for my tens. I can see that 7 and 3 make a 10. So 10 plus, well, a double fact, 2 and 2, that equals 4. So 10 plus 4. It's 14. I bring that 14 that goes in the ones place, and then the extra 10 is going to go up top. And then I go from here. All right. Well, I don't see it off the bat, but I can see 3 and 1 make 4, and then 4 and 6 makes a 10. So I have 10 plus 5, 15 plus 1 more, 16. I'm going to put the 1 right here because it's now in the hundreds, and the 6 right here. It also equals 64. Remember, friends, that whatever way works best for you is the way that you should do it. And take that idea into your next thing. So we don't have enough time to do another one, but you're going to do it on your own. And go ahead and write this down. 28 plus 23 plus 22 plus 25. Again, 28 plus 23 plus 22 plus 25. And I want you to go ahead and take this, and I want you to do this on your own, either using finding those tens or the place value chart, okay? You're going to need this for tomorrow, so practice.
Saluda Mrs. Mares y hoy continuaremos con nuestras estrategias de sumar 4 números de 2 dígitos. Prepara tu lápiz y tu papel para nuestros materiales del día de hoy. Los vamos a usar en nuestra lección, así que prepáralos y estamos listos para comenzar nuestra lección del día de hoy. Para nuestra lección de el día de hoy, vamos a practicar las dos estrategias que hemos repasado el lunes y el martes. Hoy vamos a tener una ecuación de cuatro números de dos dígitos y vamos a usar el hacer un 10 y usando nuestra tabla de unidades y decenas. Así que nuestro objetivo de hoy, como lo dice en nuestro papel aquí, dice, podré sumar, vamos a seguir sumando hasta cuatro números de dos dígitos. Si nos recordamos, dos dígitos quiere decir números como 18 que tienen unidades y decenas. Número 91 tiene unidades y decenas. Número 68 tiene unidades y decenas. Eso quiere decir con cuatro números de dos dígitos. El día de hoy, como lo dije anteriormente, vamos a practicar la estrategia haciendo un 10 y usando la tabla de unidades y decenas. Así que el día de hoy vamos a ocupar nuestro lápiz y nuestro papel para poder hacer nuestras ecuaciones. Pero antes de comenzar, como todos los días, vamos a hacer un calentamiento. Tengo aquí tres ecuaciones y en esas tres ecuaciones vamos a pensar cómo podemos resolver estas ecuaciones. Puse nuestras unidades y nuestras decenas. Por ejemplo, 28 más 32. Hemos estado practicando cómo podemos hacer un 10 para sumar y también identificando nuestras unidades y decenas. Así que primero veamos nuestras unidades. En 28 más 32, ¿cuántas unidades tengo en 28? Tengo 8 unidades. Muy bien. Y en 32, ¿cuántas unidades tengo? Tengo 2 unidades. Así que si la sumo, 8 más 2, ¿qué número me va a dar? Puede ser que tú ya lo tengas en tu mente. Si tengo 2 unidades más 8 unidades, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. ¿Cuántas voy a tener si las pongo juntas? ¿Cuánto es 2 más 8? Si lo cuento, tendría 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. ¿Cuánto sería? Y 10. 8 más 2 es igual a 10. Y como lo practicamos el lunes, vimos los dos números que dan 10 y 8 más 2 nos dan 10. Ahora ya no tengo solo 10 unidades, sino que tengo un grupo de 10. Ahora veamos nuestras decenas. ¿Cuánto es 20 más 30? ¿Cuánto es si tengo 20 más 30? ¿Cuál sería mi respuesta? 20 más 30, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. 20 más 30 es igual a 50. Y ahora puedo sumarlas juntos. ¿Cuánto es 50 más 10? 50 más 10 es igual a 60. Muy bien, tengo 6 decenas ahora porque 2 más 3 tengo 5 decenas, más una más me da 6 y tengo 0 unidades. 28 más 32 es igual a 60. Ahora intentemos nuestra segunda ecuación. 29 más un número me va a dar 60. Ahora tengo que pensar primero, 9 más qué número me va a dar 10, porque si me fijo en 60, tengo 0. Eso quiere decir que tenía 9 unidades y le agregué una más para hacer un grupo de 10. Ahora pensemos, 9 más qué número me da 10. ¿Lo tienes en mente? Yo ya lo tengo en mente. 9 más, si quieres grítalo, es 9 más 1. Muy bien. 9 más 1. Entonces mi unidad acá tiene que ser 1 para que cuando sume 9 más 1 me va a dar 10 y voy a tener 0 unidades. Ahora, si este me va a dar un 10, tengo ese 10, 2 más qué me va a dar 60. Si ya tengo el 10 para 60, porque lo hice en 9 más 1, y tengo 2, que tengo aquí en 29, ¿cuántos más necesito para llegar a 60? Tengo 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Necesito, ¿cuántos más? ¿Cuántas decenas más? Aquí las tengo. ¿Cuántas decenas más? 3 decenas. 31. Necesito 3 más para poder hacer 60. Ahora, veamos si tenemos la razón. 9 más 1, dijimos que me daba 10. Y 20, porque 2 decenas es igual a 20. 20 más 30 es igual a 50. Entonces, 50 más 10, como el 10 que le agregué de 9 más 1, es igual a 60. Muy bien, lo hicimos juntos. Ahora veamos nuestra última ecuación, si podemos encontrar el número que nos falta. 57 más qué número me va a dar 90. Ahora pensemos en nuestras unidades. Si tengo 7 unidades, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 unidades. ¿Cuántas más necesito? Porque acuérdate que si tengo un 0, quiere decir que hice un grupo de 10. ¿Cuántos más necesito para llegar a 10? 7 más qué me da 10. Pensemos, 7 más qué número me da 10. ¿Ya lo tengo en mente? ¿Lo tienes tú en mente? Grítalo si quieres. 7 más 3. Muy bien. 7, 8, 9, 10. Tengo 10 que van a ser un grupo de 10. Lo puedo cambiar y puedo decir adiós a las unidades y lo hice en un grupo de 10. Así que mi otra unidad tiene que ser 3 porque tengo que llegar a 10. Ahora, si tengo 5 aquí, 5 decenas, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, ¿cuántas más le tengo que agregar para que llegue a 90? Si ya tengo el 10 de 7 más 3, tengo 5 decenas, 6, ¿cuántas más necesito para 9? 7, 8, 9. ¿Le tengo que sumar cuántas decenas? ¿Cuántas hay aquí? 3 decenas. Y vamos a verificar si estamos correctos. Vamos a sumar. 7 más 3 es igual a 10. Y 5 decenas más 3 decenas es 50 más 30, que me dio 80, porque sé que 5 más 3 es 8. 80 más 10 es igual a 90. Muy bien, ya calentamos nuestra mente y comenzamos a pensar qué números nos dan 10 para así saber cómo vamos a resolver nuestra ecuación. Así que listos para nuestra ecuación. Para tu lápiz y tu papel y vamos a escribir esta ecuación juntos. 52 más 37 más 12 más 63. Una vez más para que tú lo escribas. 52 más 37 más 12 más 63. Muy bien. Vamos a preparar y vamos a preparar nuestra mente para pensar en nuestra primera estrategia. Nuestro objetivo decía que vamos a intentar haciendo un 10 y usando la tabla de unidades y decenas. Haciendo un 10 lo vamos a hacer primero y nuestra tabla va a ser para después. Así que veamos nuestros cuatro números y primero hagamos un círculo en nuestras unidades. Tengo 2, 7, 2 y 3. Ahorita tengo en mente, porque sé qué números hacen un 10, ya tengo en mente dos números que me van a ayudar a hacer un grupo de 10. ¿Tienes tú en mente esos dos números? A ver si los puedes encontrar en 2, 7, 2 y 3. 2 más 3, 2 más 7, 2 más 7 o 7 más 3. Ya lo tengo en mi mente. Muy bien, ahora los vamos a sumar. Yo sé que 7 y 3 me van a dar un 10. Luego también sé que 2 más 2, tengo aquí otras unidades, es igual a 4. Así que ahorita tengo 4 más 10, que son todas mis unidades, es igual a 14. Esas son mis unidades. Todavía no he sumado mis decenas. Ahora veamos nuestras decenas. Tengo 5, 3, 1 y 6. ¿Qué es lo mismo que 5 decenas? ¿Qué número es igual a 5 decenas? Sería 50. ¿Qué número es igual a 3 decenas? ¿Qué número sería? 30. ¿Qué número es igual a una decena? 10. ¿Y qué número es igual a 6 decenas? 60. Muy bien. Ahora vamos a sumar nuestras decenas. 50 más 30 más 10 más 60. Yo sé que 5 más 3 es 8. Aquí voy a tener 80. Y 10 más 60 es 70. Ahora tengo que sumar 80 más 70. 8 más 7, si tengo 8 decenas, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 decenas. Y le tengo que agregar 7 decenas más. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wow, vamos a tener un número muy grande. Ahora, si tengo 80 más 70, 80, 90 y 100. Tengo un 100, 110, 120, 130, 140, 150. 80 más 70 es 150. Ahora le tengo que agregar mis 14 unidades. 150 más 14. Tengo aquí un 10 y 4 unidades, porque 14 es igual a un 10, una decena, y 4 unidades. Tengo 150 más 100 más un 10 es 160. 161, 162, 163, 164. Mi respuesta es 164. Muy bien. Ahora vamos a ver si estamos en lo correcto usando nuestra tabla de unidades y decenas. Así que pongamos nuestros números en nuestra tabla. 52, dijimos que tiene ¿cuántas unidades? 2. ¿Y cuántas decenas? 5. 37 tiene ¿cuántas unidades? 7. ¿Y cuántas decenas? 3. 12 tiene ¿cuántas unidades? 2. ¿Y cuántas decenas? Una decena. Y 63 tiene 3 unidades. ¿Y cuántas decenas? 6 decenas. Muy bien. Ahora podemos sumar nuestras unidades primero y luego nuestras decenas para ver si tenemos el mismo resultado. 2 más 7 es igual a 7, 8, 9. 2 más 3 es igual a 2 más 3, 1, 2, 3, 5. Y 9 más 5, porque ahora tengo estos dos números que todavía los tengo que sumar, es igual a 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Muy bien. Tenemos lo mismo que teníamos aquí arriba. Ahora veamos nuestras decenas. 5 más 3 es igual a, o 50 más 30 es igual a 80. Y 10 más 60 es igual, porque una decena es igual a 10 y 6 decenas es igual a 60. 10 más 60 es 70 y 80 más 70 es igual a, aquí lo vimos, 150. Y 150 más 14, porque vamos a poner nuestras unidades y decenas juntos, es igual a 164. Y tenemos la misma respuestas. Así que el día de hoy practicamos cómo hacer un 10 para poder ayudarnos a sumar y hacer un grupo de 10. Sumamos nuestras unidades primero y luego nuestras decenas en nuestra tabla de unidades y decenas. Así que el día de hoy practicamos lo que vimos el lunes, el martes. Y en tu casa vamos a practicar, vas a practicar tú una ecuación. Puedes usar cualquier estrategia que tú quieras. Tu ecuación es 28 más 23 más 22 más 25. Una vez más, escríbelo en tu papel. 28 más 23 más 22, más 25. El día de mañana haremos más estrategias. Vamos a seguir practicando estas dos estrategias con una historia de matemática. Nos veremos mañana.